for that car and knife attack at Ohio State University that injured 11 people. Plus, the details tonight on what is described as the Republicans' lightning strike plan to deal with Obamacare in the very first days of the Trump administration. What does Trump's latest appointment tell us about where he's going? Trump transition team member Anthony Scaramucci and former assistant
by switching to AT&T.
What?
And you got unlimited data because you have DirecTV. Okay, just a few more steps.
Door!
Get the iPhone 7 on us and unlimited data when you switch to AT&T and have DirecTV.
The best ideas are solving common problems. My problem? Like a lot of other people, I couldn't find a shirt that looked good on top. So this became my passion, to design a shirt that captures the perfect balance between length and fit. Easy to say, not that easy to do, but with some innovative design changes, we did. Our problem, my solution, on Tugit.com.
Jackson, we present.
incentives with Epsom Player. Little Johnson, a short drive for everyone. It's savings like nowhere else. Shop online now at BillJacksonAuto.com.
Be spearheaded by Congressman Tom Price, the president-elect's pick, to head up Health and Human Services, and the lawmaker who tried for years to dismantle Obamacare and got very specific about how to do it. So how is this going to work? In a moment, we will speak with Trump transition team member Anthony Scaramucci and former President Bill Clinton assistant Matt Bennett, but first to Trace Gallagher, who today talked with some of the top experts in the country on what we're likely in store for here. Trace?
Congressman Price, an orthopedic surgeon by trade, says his major complaint about Obamacare is that it puts the government in the middle of the doctor-patient relationship. Price has introduced his own legislation to repeal and replace the Affordable Care Act in each of the past three sessions of Congress. And his plan now serves as the basis for the health care proposal unveiled by House Speaker Paul Ryan. The main points of Price's plan are to offer fixed tax credits so people can buy their own insurance on the private market, to expand health savings accounts, allowing people to use pre-tax dollars to pay for health care, and to give the states federal money to help cover people with existing conditions who cannot afford private health insurance. We just spoke to a conservative health policy advisor who thinks Tom Price is on the right track. Watch. Price's nomination process could be a bit rocky. Here it is.
When it comes to issues like Medicare, the Affordable Care Act, and Planned Parenthood, Congressman Price and the average American couldn't be further apart.
Sure adds that Republicans will rue the day they tried to abolish Obamacare, but many Republicans believe acting on Obamacare in the first 100 days with a so-called lightning strike bill would be a big-ticket victory. Although House Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy cautioned that it might be best to start by repealing the Affordable Care Act, which then gives Congress time to replace it. Thank you.
Trace, thank you. Turning out more, Anthony Scaramucci and Matt Bennett. Great to see you both. So, Matt, let me start with you as the Democrat on this. So the idea is that pre-existing condition coverage will continue, but the thing that funded that made that possible under Obamacare, was a mandate that required everybody buy in, including the unhealthy people, which they kind of weren't doing, which has led to some of the problems. So this plan that Congressman Price has suggested, has presented, says, well, we'll still cover those pre-existing conditions, but you're going to get like a tax credit. Oh, wait, stand by, here's McCarthy.
Century. Yeah.
in March of, 2016, Mitt Romney just savaged Donald Trump. Right before that, third Fox News debate that we held at the Detroit Theater in Michigan, Romney's original home state. And tonight you heard a very different tone, as so often happens in politics. I'm going to bring back in our guests here and just switch the topic up, guys, because we're not talking about a lot here, but Mitt Romney sounds very different tonight, Matt, than we ever heard him sound before. And the question is whether that is the prelude to a candidate appointment in your view.
Yeah, it's a good question. Look, Mitt Romney is a class act. He has been comporting himself that way since the election, and it's no surprise that he is making himself available to his elect, despite the fact that, as you point out, he made very, very clear what he thinks of Donald Trump, what he thought of him as a candidate, and what he thought of him as a potential president. But he's a guy that believes that if he could help the country by serving Secretary of State, he should do that, and I commend him for it. I can tell you this, a lot of Democrats are rooting for him to get that job because he's a stable and known quantity, and I think that would be a good face for us to the world.
Anthony, so the argument is that Mitt Romney could go in there and be sort of the good cop, as opposed to the bad cop elements already chosen by Team Trump, meaning the guys who are going to rough and tumble and ready to shake up some feathers, and Romney's a little bit more, as Matt points out, stable. But you heard Newt Gingrich's objections to him. Rudy Giuliani's, Kellyanne Conway have a chance in your view.
Well, he certainly has a chance because he obviously would be at the dinner meeting, maybe, but what I love about Governor Romney, $6 billion. Now, having said that, there are other candidates that are being looked at, and what I have to respect about the president-elect is really taking this process very, very seriously, where he is looking at the way CEO would, and he's bringing on 5 or 6 really well-qualified candidates. And so, what we saw there, though, I just would say that if we were back in the day with Instagram and Twitter, and we saw what William Seward said about Abraham Lincoln, it was probably even more difficult than the words that Governor Romney mentioned back in March. So I'm glad these guys are coming together. They're both great Americans, and we need to unite as a party, but also as a country.
All right, guys, we will pull our Obamacare repeal and replace discussion for another night, and because there's a lot going on there, too. We'll see what Tom Price does if he gets confirmed as HHS Secretary. Great to see you both. Thank you.
Good night, thanks.
Well, also tonight, breaking news on the attack at Ohio State University. Yes, don't go away.
Are you happy with your Banjo? I wasn't. I thought I didn't have the money until I learned about Bath Fitter wants a new bathtub. Right over your old one. Isn't that amazing? Bath Fitter will measure, make, and install right over your existing tub. And only Bath Fitter has seamless walls, which guarantees a watertight fit. Plus, they do it all in just one day. That's my favorite part. Book a free consultation and find out for yourself. Call today or learn more at bathfitter.com.
You may know us for our quality fitters. You might know we're the world's largest independent refiner, or even that we're in the Fortune 500 top 20. But do you know we've given over $100 million for children's charities, delivering more than 45,000 meals and wheels, and given over $10 million for higher education? To appreciate a company's true value, you have to understand the heart of its people. gluten free.
Nothing says treat yourself like Red Lobster's holiday seafood celebration. So try new dishes like the Grand Seafood Feast and Wild Caught Lobster and Shrimp Trio with a lobster mac and cheese topped lobster soup. Come treat yourself to feast fit for the season before it ends.
Better buckle up. That inactive satellite radio of yours is ready to roll. Because the SiriusXM free listening event is on right now. Just hit the stop button in your car and listen free from November 29th. That's right. Two glorious weeks of commercial-free music, plus talk, sports, comedy, news, and more. Your ride has never, ever rocked like this. Oh yeah, SiriusXM is on free right now. So tune in, let's ride.
One test drive in a Mazda 6. It's one vet and one friend. One ride in a Mazda 3. Delivers one hot meal to someone in need. Test drive in a Mazda during the drive-through event and we'll give that 1 hour of our time to local causes. Then we'll donate to St. Jude or a charity you choose when you buy a new Mazda. Because driving matters most when you're driving for good.
Breaking new developments in the wake of yesterday's car and knife attack at Ohio State University by suspect Abdul Razak Ali Atan. 11 people were injured in that campus attack, and now ISIS has claimed responsibility. Fox's Mike Tobin has the latest details from Columbus, Ohio. Mike?
Hi, Megan. Atan was a consumer of ISIS propaganda. This according to an investigator speaking with Fox News. Also, there are growing indications that he had self-radicalized. He got online. He ranted about the treatment of Muslims. He mentioned things like a boiling point. He threatened sleeper cells. He had praised Anwar Awlaki as a hero. That's a U.S.-born al-Qaeda cleric who became an icon of jihad wannabes online after he was killed by a U.S. drone strike some 5 years ago. Now, the attack came less than a month after the Department of Homeland Security warned of a growing threat from homegrown attacks on soft targets in public gatherings. Propaganda encouraged simple weapons like knives and cars. What stands in contrast to the warning is Atan himself. He was concerned about the image of Muslims, particularly here on campus. He was a good student. He had just transferred to a Big Ten university. Neighbors said he was a good kid from a big family. They're flabbergasted about what happened here. The Somali community just held a press conference tonight. The local Somali community tried to put as much distance between themselves as they could and Atan. Megan?
Mike, thank you. Well, shortly after the OSU attack, former vice presidential nominee Senator Tim Kaine was quick to condemn guns, initially tweeting, quote, deeply saddened by the senseless act of gun violence at Ohio State this morning. Praying for the injured and the entire Buckeye community. He later retracted that statement. Then an internet talk show host seemed to make it a race thing, tweeting, quote, so white? Police officer Alan Haruchko, who shot and killed the black Somali stabbing suspect in Ohio, is being paraded as a hero. That's interesting. And an OSU staffer allegedly posted on Facebook asking others to find compassion for the suspect. Dana Lash is the host of Dana on UNH TV, and Nikki Cox is the host of The Filter in SiriusXM Partners Chris Siebel. So, Nikki, let me start with you on Tim Kaine. In his defense, we've seen so many of these mass violence incidents on college campuses and elsewhere, and they've involved guns, they've involved many things, but again, to get out ahead of the skis and call it a senseless act of gun violence when it was...